Escorts to the colour.
Defender of the faith,
To our trusty and well-beloved Lieutenant General Sir Jeremiah Mateparae, Knight Grand Companion of our New Zealand Order of Merit, Companion of our Service Order, greeting. We do by this our commission, under the seal of New Zealand, appoint you, the said Lieutenant General Sir Jeremiah Mateparae, to be, during our pleasure, our Governor General and Commander-in-Chief in and over our realm of New Zealand. And we do hereby authorize and empower you to exercise the powers and authorities conferred on our Governor-General and our Commander-in-Chief by our letters patent under the seal of New Zealand, bearing date the 28th day of October 1983, and constituting the office of Governor-General and Commander-in-Chief in and over our realm of New Zealand, or by any other letters patent, altering, amending, or substituting for the same. And we do hereby command you to do and execute those powers and authorities according to the tenor of the said letters patent and of this our commission, and such laws as are now or shall hereafter be in force in our realm of New Zealand or in any part thereof. And we do hereby declare that this our commission shall take effect on the 31st day of August 2011. We do hereby direct that you shall, as soon as convenient after this our commission takes effect, and before entering on any of the duties of the Office of Governor-General and Commander-in-Chief, cause this our commission to be publicly read in accordance with Clause 5 of the said letters patent, and that you shall, immediately after this our commission has been so publicly read, take, as required by the said letters patent, the oath of allegiance and the oath for the due execution of the Office of Governor-General. We do hereby direct and enjoin our ministers of the Crown and other officers and all other inhabitants of our realm of New Zealand to take notice of this, our commission, and to comply accordingly. Given at our court at St. James's and issued under the seal of New Zealand this 17th day of August 2011, in the 60th year of our reign, by Her Majesty's command.
Ko tokerau, me te Ross the Painter. Tarako, Pirihuma, Pupu Hokiaha, Yaya Nai, Tiara Kinui, Queenie Yer, Harpete, Tetuarua, Queenie Old Mutiri, Metona Kahui, Fakahik, and the Emi of the Fedua Old Mutiri. Aiki te orato ture me orato tikanga. Ko te atua nei hoki, taku pō.
everybody please stand?
Thank you. Rōra ngā tira mā e huhui nei, ngā iwi sūjiri, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tātou. We are here today to welcome Lieutenant Sūjiri Mateparae as Governor General of the Realm of New Zealand. Sūjiri is New Zealand's 20th Governor General. He's an excellent choice for the role, and it's a great privilege to welcome him here today. Sūjiri joins a small group of distinguished New Zealanders who have served the people of New Zealand as the Queen's representative. New Zealand is very fortunate to have such a high calibre of people willing to serve our country in this way. The Governor General has a unique role in New Zealand. They highlight what it means to be a Kiwi. They celebrate why New Zealand is such a great place to live. They inspire young New Zealanders. They acknowledge the highest achievements of our people. They share in sorrow at difficult times. They work alongside people young and old in our communities. And of course, there are the formal duties of office. The Governor General is a constitutional linchpin. They ensure the smooth functioning of our system of government. They sign legislation, appoint ministers, attend executive council, and read the speech from the throne. These functions, on behalf of the Queen and on the advice of ministers, are essential but often unseen. For example, one of Sūjiri's first significant constitutional functions will be signing the writ that brings about the 2011 general election. I know that Sūjiri will carry out all of these functions of Governor General with great pride and enthusiasm. Sūjiri is an outstanding leader with a 38-year military career behind him. He was born in Whanganui. His tribal affiliations are to Ngāti Tuwharetoa and Ngāti Kainunu. He also has links to Tuhoe and tribes in the Upper Whanganui. Sūjiri joined the New Zealand Army in 1972 and rose through the ranks, serving and commanding in a variety of roles. He became Chief of Army in 2002 and Chief of the Defence Force in 2006. From February to July this year, he was the Director of the Government Communications Security Bureau. Sūjiri's service to New Zealand to date has been exemplary. He is a warm, engaging and highly regarded New Zealander. I believe Sūjiri will bring great mana and a wide range of qualities to this role, including judgment, energy and enthusiasm for encouraging excellence in others. It will be a busy term of office, starting with the Pacific Island Forum next week, the Rugby World Cup and the general election this year. Next year is the Queen's Diamond Jubilee. There will be another general election in 2014, and in 2015 we will mark the centenary of the First World War. Sūjiri is one of our younger Governor-Generals, and he's New Zealand's second Governor-General of Māori descent. Sadly, we have recently had reason to reflect on the term of New Zealand's first Governor-General of Māori descent, Sir Paul Reeves. Sir Paul, who passed away this month, demonstrated a way of being Governor General that remained true to his background and his personal convictions. I'm sure Sūjiri will find his own way to bring his experience and interests to the role of Governor General. I'd like to acknowledge the people of Ngāti Tuwharetoa who have accompanied Sūjiri today, and other Māori leaders and iwi representatives. And I'd also like to thank the superb Ka Pahaka group the welcome you have given Sir Jerry today. Sir Jerry is married to Lady Janine Mateparae, and together they have 5 children. I'd like to welcome you all and acknowledge the contribution you will make as Sir Jerry carries out his role as Governor General. Sir Jerry, I say thank you for accepting this role on behalf of the government and the people of New Zealand. I'd like to wish you well for your term. Nā reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
His Excellency Lieutenant General, the Right Honourable Sir Jerry Mateparae, Governor General of New Zealand.
I hei lodo, e ngā mana, e ngā reo, e ngā maunga, e ngā awa awa, e ngā pātako o ngā taunga tūringo, tēnā koutou. Prime Minister and Mrs. Key, Chief Justice, Mr. Speaker, members of the Executive Council and members of the New Zealand Parliament, Dean and members of the Diplomatic Corps, Chief of Defence Force, Service Chiefs, and defence representatives, officials, whānau, friends, ladies and gentlemen, kia ora koutou katoa. Prime Minister, thank you for your words of welcome and the sentiments you've expressed in your address. Janine and I and our family are delighted to have made it to this point and what shows all the signs of being a wonderful day. For my part, being here is an extraordinary honour. Almost every day over the past 6 months, I've reflected on this honour. And when I woke up this morning, I gave myself one more pinch just in case. At the same time, it is with some trepidation that we look ahead to what the next 5 years holds. The 6 months since I was named as New Zealand's 20th Governor General passed very quickly. During that time, as a family, we've both prepared ourselves and been prepared by others for the opportunities that will come with the role. We've been heartened by the generosity of spirit and support that many New Zealanders have shown in congratulating us. Strangers have approached us in the street and in shops to wish us well. A highlight for us was the special audience with Her Majesty the Queen of New Zealand in June. The prospect of being able to serve both our Queen and the people of New Zealand as Governor General is a privilege that only a few people have the opportunity to take up. The men and women who have preceded me all brought their unique qualities, character, energy and mana to the role. They have been steadfast like Te Tokatumua, the rock standing in the ocean. The example they have set gives me cause to be optimistic about what lies ahead. And that has been confirmed as I have drawn on the wisdom of 5 of my predecessors. It is with considerable sadness that I remember Sir Paul Reeves, a generous, thoughtful, and compassionate man, nō reira tā pau, moi mai, moi mai, moi mai. I also acknowledge Dame Catherine Tizard, Sir Michael Hardy-Boys, Dame Sylvia Cartwright, and Sir Anand Satchin, who have been so generous and open in sharing their experiences. One of the unfortunate things with protocols of the office is that I am only now able to publicly acknowledge with them in absentia Sir Anand and Sir Lady Susan for their contributions in the role. As he undertook to do so at his swearing in, Sir Anand served faithfully and impartially, and he did that with dignity, warmth and compassion. Janine and I wish them well as they ease back into a life more ordinary. Like my predecessors, I have taken the oath of allegiance to Her Majesty the Queen of New Zealand and the oath of office. The two oaths together reflect my commitment to our country and the people of the realm of New Zealand, including the Cook Islands, Niue and Tokelau, that I will serve faithfully and impartially. The values and undertakings in these oaths are very important to me. In the past 12 months, we in New Zealand have had some difficult times. And anniversaries of events will test us again in the coming months. However, as a people, New Zealanders, whether we be of Maori, British, European, Pacific Island, Asian or other descent, have caused to see a silver lining in adversity. The Kiwi spirit, companionship, and with that, a generosity, compassion, and resolve when things need to be done, has been evident. As I've reflected on my new role, what I am looking forward to most is the opportunity of meeting and getting to know people, being able to support in the sad times, but also to celebrate successes, achievements, and the good times. My view reflects the sentiment of the proverb, "He aha te mea nui o te ao." What is the most important thing in the world? The answer is e tangata, e tangata, e tangata. It is people, it is people, it is people. Over the next 5 years, I want to take the opportunity to meet and talk to as many New Zealanders as I can. There are many people who will recognise me from my time as the Chief of Defence Force. Still more will have no knowledge of me. What I identify as the essence of being a New Zealander was put neatly by Sir Edmund Hillary when he said that, in some ways, I believe I epitomise the average New Zealander. I have modest abilities. I combine these with a good deal of determination, and I'd rather like to succeed. As a people, New Zealanders are in equal measures informal, strong-willed, competitive, and yet also modest about all we have achieved. We have a strong sense of community, where public spiritedness is appreciated and valued. We are inclined to be considerate and to lend a helping hand to those in need. Yet we also like to get on and do stuff. We admire individual ingenuity and those who have a sense of adventure. Looking ahead to our 5-year adventure, it is likely that Janine and I will become known better by New Zealanders as we travel together in the realm of New Zealand and beyond. You will see we are ordinary folk. We have been given a special opportunity. It is our hope that we can encourage people to think about how New Zealanders can make a difference. We look forward to promoting and celebrating the things that positively unite us as New Zealanders, our virtues, our heritage, our way of life, and our future. We also want to strengthen the bonds of fraternity between all for whom Aotearoa New Zealand is our tūranga wairua. Regardless of whether you or your ancestors came here 10 years ago, 100 years ago, or over 1,000 years ago. It will have been obvious that Janine and my being here has been accomplished with the support of our immediate family, our extended whānau, our iwi, and our friends. We appreciate their encouragement, their guidance, and their patience. I also want to thank the people who have accommodated our whims, fancies, and requests with this ceremony. Getting the invitations out has been no small challenge. When I think about what lies in store for us over the next 5 years, it's not easy thinking beyond the events that will unfold over the next 3 months. An election, and of course, the Rugby World Cup. With the former, I will exercise my constitutional responsibilities impartially with the advice of many eminently qualified people. With the latter, like most New Zealanders, I will be taking a keen and of course less than impartial interest in in the result. Kia ora.
Thank you.